Hi there folks, Rob Helean with your Asian Session Preview for Friday, 18th of November, 2011. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Purpose is to teach you accepted methods of technical and fundamental analysis. We do this within the live market conditions. Please remember your past performance does not predict future results, and please do not trade the money you cannot afford to part ways with. Okay guys, let's just continue what we're looking at. The last video that we're looking at the pound, let's give you a quick update. If you don't remember, the previous video I did earlier in the week will tell you. But we're looking at all the support here. And previously, when I made a video, we were here. And I said, while we've got support there, you might want to take yourself a little shot and until that would break. Okay. Now, personally, took a shot in there. Personally, actually took a little... took a little loss in there, but that was plan A, if you like. And plan B was going to be a break and continuation of that area, okay? And that's exactly what we got. So that was going to be plan B, was going to be break. And what I was telling my class was, if that breaks, just continue trying to ride the 15-minute swings and move fibs and things until it doesn't want to anymore, and we get that a bit of a decent pullback. Well, that decent pullback could be what is happening right now. And now the fact that we've broken this trap, I'm gonna remain bearish on it. Okay, so I'm gonna continue looking to short this pair. So if we just look at the 15-minute chart here, I would be quite happy to just continue trying to take swing fibs down, and if we hoping to make new lows down there, and then be looking for something like this. I'll just move this chart across. At some stage you would have to expect, in normal trading conditions, we will get a bigger pullback. So if we got something like this leading up to Asia, I would even, we've been taking a lot of scalpy 15-minute swings in Asia lately, just due to what's been on offer. Been working, been making a few pips with it and things like that. And I'd continue that fashion with this pair, got the fresh lows here, and then I would continue to take the swings until it didn't want to happen anymore. And then I would just line up the entire drop and take a move fib of that drop and look to continue that trend. I'm going to remain bearish on it. I think fundamentally what's going on, I think we're slowly making our ways to the short side, and besides sort of giant daily fibs, there's nothing really at home, and those things take a while to sort themselves out, I should say. So pretty much going to look for a rinse and repeat of yesterday, if you like. If we just look at what happened yesterday, this was the trade plans we spoke about in Asia yesterday. Was just trying to keep this momentum to the downside. There's little swings in here, and you can just keep scalping your way around, okay, until those swings run out of steam. So if you were trading and you're a scalper, you might have taken a little shot in there, a little shot in there, made yourself a few pips, and then a break even or even a small loss on the pullback here. And once that happens, you're looking to take a fib of that entire drop back to resistance, and then short it again. Okay, now, I suggest waiting for a shorter term change of trend, like a 2 or 3 minute chart change of trend at the fib level there, okay, and then look to short. Now, in this case, the short didn't, definitely not a loss, okay, but it basically fibbed the rise, and we sort of continued our way up. Look where we went to, 4 hour 21. Known area of resistance here, and subsequently change trend on the 15-minute chart back to the downside. And that's why I'm mentioning I would just look to continue that trend. Now, when I say 15-minute swings, okay, one of the things I've been thinking and teaching in boot camp is just actually take a swing and don't be afraid to get out of it. We've been looking to sort of doing the maths and things. If you got a pullback here, say on this pound, like to here, and shorted it, it'll stop up here somewhere, and you made it down decently to some lows, doesn't have to go and you know, crash through the earth, but you make 30, 40 pips on something like that, there's actually nothing wrong with getting out of that, taking your money, and then just lining up another swing and just trying to do it again. Just like a little rinse and repeat. Go and take 30, 40 pips on a swing, get out of it, do it again, get out of it, do it again, until it doesn't want to do it anymore. You'd be surprised how many times you line those up and how often you actually get lucky, line up two or three in a row and have yourselves a 100 pip day. And sometimes it's a lot better than these trades where you take the one trade, you look to hold on to it, okay, it comes down, reverses fibs, and then reverses on you, and you've got nothing to show for yourself, all that effort you've put in front of a computer, and you've taken maybe a loss or a break even for the day, sort of a little frustrating. So there's something to think about there. I'm gonna talk a lot more about that thing in future videos. We'll wrap it up there, guys, but looking to continue short with these pairs. I think we've just found some decent resistance, and we'll get you updated next week with what's going on. But overall, looks like USD weakness, strength, sorry, and going to look to continue that. Okay. By the way, I'm back at FX Street for every Tuesday starting next week, and I've got the link. I'll put it in the text section of this video. And when I was at FX Street back in September, there was a lot of demand for some pivot point training. And so that's what we'll kick off this new series of webinars with. We'll go and talk everything pivots. So look forward to seeing you there. Have yourselves a good weekend, guys, and we'll catch you next week. Cheers.